just as there is a lot of information about Modbus RTU Master. It has been very difficult for us to find it on Modbus RTU Slave. In this video we will configure an ESP01 relay as Modbus RTU Slave. The ESP01 is based on an ESP8266 microprocessor. What will we program with Arduino IDE? Regarding the hardware to carry out the tests, we have implemented the scheme above. In the slave, that is the objective of this video. We introduce a schematic that configures it as a thermostat using a DS18B20 probe. For communication we use TTL to RS485 cards. As for the master, we use another ESP01 relay, what acts as a bridge with Home Assistant. Let's start by downloading the library Modbus Master Slave for Arduino Master. We launch the Arduino IDE. Now we will install the library. For sensor reading, we also have to have the libraries installed. One wire versus Dallas temperature. We replace the empty program with the one downloaded from the link in the description. If you have to connect to an existing network, you will have to change the baud parity and stop bits configuration to match the master. Program explanation. First we load the libraries. We configure the one-wire bus and the sensor. Note, to find out the sensor address there is a program in the library examples. We declare variables. And in the setup we initialize communication and variables. The loop controls the flow of the program. When updating registers we invert the relay output. We update the temperature and at the end, we control the thermostat. We connect the ESP01 USB with an ESP01 card and load the program. In the video on this channel, Modbus RTU to Home Assistant with TTL to RS485 electronic board and ESP01 relay. It is explained in great detail. We hope it finishes flashing. We remove the USB and the slave is ready. We go to Home Assistant to configure the master. We have to have the ESP Home plugin installed in Home Assistant. We go to ESP Home and click on New Device. Continue. We write the name of the master device, Modbus. Next, we choose the device, in our case ESP8266. Install. Cancel. Edit of the newly created device. We customize the program. After logger with three spaces we put baud underscore rate, 0. And a line break, enter. We select captive underscore portal. We replace it with the YAML code downloaded from our page. Link in video description. YAML code explanation. Firstly, we configure a fixed IP to replace with a free one within its range. After captive underscore portal, we configure the Modbus network with its communication parameters. Also the slave. Now the slave 1 temperature sensor. With the address of the first record, the data type, name and ID for Home Assistant. We configure the switches that control the slave and master relays. Finally, 2 number type entities to send. The maximum and minimum reference values for thermostat control. We save. Install. Plug into this computer. We wait and download project. Open ESP Home Web. Connect. We connect the USB/ES01 with the ESP01 to configure as master. We select and connect. Install. We select the downloaded file, open. Install. We hope it finishes flashing. We close message. ESP Home Web tab. We close dialog. We remove the USB/ESP01. Now we must start the installation. Put the flashed microprocessor boards in the ESP01 relay. All connections made. And we give tension. A notification appears. We click. Check it out. Set up. Send. Finish. We select the area and finish. The device already appears as an integration. But the entities still do not appear, switch sensors. We believe that after a while they would appear worse. We are going to restart the YAML configuration. Tools for developers. Restart. Fast charge. We return to settings, devices and services. ESP Home. We check that the entities have been created. We enter the device. These entities should appear. We check the movement of the relays. Add to control panel, controls. Following. Add to dashboard. Let's go to the control panel, home. Edition. Edit. Modbus card. We uncheck show header switch. We mark colored icons according to the state. We add Modbus temperature. We click on Show Code Editor. We select all the entities and copy. Save. Add card. We select historical graph. In hours to display we enter 0.05. We select Show Code Editor. We select the default entity and paste. Save. Done. We can do some tests with the switches, changing the references or warming up the probe to see. As the relay via Modbus stops when passing the maximum temperature and starts when going below the minimum.
We would appreciate it. I like it. Subscribe and activate notifications.